Hi student, today we have to discuss about selection of transducer. First, the meaning of selection. Selection means what are all the factors to be influence for selecting a transducer. So just you have to first consider what are the factors to be influencing the choice of transducer. For example, before going to that, just we go to some example, real-time example. Since real-time example, take a example, a mobile phone. Okay, because nowadays everyone have a mobile phone. Okay, so before going to a purchase, a mobile, just you have to consider what are all the parameters. Just you have to everyone, different persons, every person's having some different factors. For example, some people having interested in photography or selfies, so they have to consider high resolution camera. Some other people having a good speed of processor, just they have to searching the processor, maybe a selection parameters having a just a camera or processor based on the speed, processor speed, or next a memory. So someone having different people having they will need a huge amount of space for storage, different kinds of files. So they have to consider memory, huge memory, either 64 GB or 128 GB. Nowadays in advanced mobile phone having up to 1 TB of 512 GB, up to 1 TB is also available in market. Okay, so and the next one is the battery. It's a very very important parameter. Okay, battery is a major vital role in a mobile phone. Okay, battery size and battery capacity. So these are all the kinds of factors to be influenced for selecting the mobile. So the same concept to be, just you have to switch over to transducer. Okay, so in transducer, in the first parameter for selecting a transducer, nature of measurement. Okay, it means the selection of transducer will naturally depend upon the measured quantity. Okay, so just you have to measure the any natural quantity. For example, to measure the temperature measurement, just you have to using thermistor, okay, or thermal sensor, a temperature sensor. So any temperature sensor, or either like a thermistor or thermometer or something, RTD something, just you have to take any kind of temperature sensor. Or another example, like to measure the stress or force, just using strain gauge. So based upon the natural condition. Okay, either this is a simple example, I have to tell another examples, so like displacement or pH value or liquid flow, water flow, something. So different kinds of example, any natural quantities to be measured. That kind of transducer, that is the factor for selecting of nature of measurement. Okay, where it is a sensor, maybe a transducer to be used for measure the natural quantity. So that is a first choice of transducer. Second one is a loading effect. So this is all important one. Loading effect. Okay. Loading effect means the transducer should have high input impedance. Okay. Just you have to select the transducer having a high input impedance and low output impedance. Okay, this you have to select the transducer having high input impedance. The output is low, high input impedance, the output is low impedance, low output impedance. So thus it means this impedance means it is a resistance and reactance losses. Okay, so resistance plus reactance both are combined is called impedance. Thus every transducer have to be connected in some input source like electricity. Okay, that's that is electricity having maybe some transducer having inductive coils, that type of transducers having resistance and reactance losses. So that is to be input is high because input source is sometime having some surge is produced or some huge amount high voltage due to short circuit time. Maybe the input voltage should be maybe high or input current or to be high. So at that situation the transducer withstand. Okay, that only we have to consider high input impedance. Okay, at the same time the output of the transducer is low impedance or very very minimum impedance because the output of transducer is to be connected in any measuring instrument. Okay, either to be connected in microprocessor or microcontroller or maybe a PC, personal computer, for calculating for other process. Maybe that impedance, maybe the output side impedance is very high means the signal to be lost. Okay, resistance reactance means the maybe every transducer can send the information through cable. Okay, impedance may be high means it is to be lost up to reach to sending maybe receiving end, it will be lost. So they have to so there is a output of the transducer is impedance is very very low. Just you have to consider very low impedance. Okay, that is a concept of loading effect. And so third parameters, third parameter is environmental. Environmental, environment compatibility. Okay, so these parameter to be considered for most of the device. Okay, in which area does you have to using the transducer? Maybe this you have to measure the temperature, mean high temperature area. Okay, some of the industries having a very huge temperature. At that place, thus you have to using some kind various kind of transducer. The transducer have withstand for huge temperature. Okay, and also some other example, chemical industry. Thus you have to use a transducer in chemical industry. At the time, the transducer cannot corrode using some chemicals. Okay, and also the transducer withstand for either vibration or like pressure, shock or electromagnetic interference. Okay, some other electromagnetic lines are nearby means it will not affect the actual transducer. Okay, so just you have to select the transducer under specified environmental condition. Okay, so just you have to select different kinds of environmental condition. Just you have to select based on that condition, environmental condition, just you have to select the transducer. Okay, so this is the third one, environmental compatibility. And the fourth one is okay there's third one fourth one is electrical aspect. Is a major one, okay, because we are all electrical engineer, so you have to consider the electrical aspect of electrical aspect of selecting the transducer. That means the transducer electrical aspect means the transducer working voltage or working current or transducer power consumption and type of cable, which type of cable or connectors or a length of the cable. So these are all the factors to be under the category of electrical aspect. Okay, this is simple. Selecting transducer based on working voltage, based on working voltage, current, cable size and length. So how many distance you have to cover the transducer. Okay, so these are all the factors to be considered for electrical aspect of selecting the transducer. And another important one is to noise, the ratio of noise and frequency response, frequency response limitation. So you got to select the transducer have very less noise and frequency response. Okay, in case it should be affected noise means the output of the transducer may be malfunction. So you will not get an exact answer, exact output. Okay, it is a electrical aspect. And the fifth one is a static characteristics. So these are all the important characteristics. So it means the transducer should be free from load alignment. Okay, so static means steady state. Okay, so the following factors are the static characteristics. So the first one is low non-linearity. So here, what is the difference between linearity and non-linearity? So linear means, just I have to draw some graph. It's like a input, it's like a output. It's x-axis and y-axis. Just you have to consider x-axis input and y-axis an output. So input is 0, output also 0. So input gradually increase, output also gradually increase. So it will go to this kind. That is a linear. So that one is a linear curve. Non-linear means, so go to same graph, so y-axis and x-axis, input and output. Okay, it is to be maybe input varied, output does not get a corresponding output. Okay, input is increased, but at the same time the output something decrease will move this kind of wave. So that means the input does not respond for output. Okay, that kind of is waveform is non-linear. Okay, so to reduce the non-linearity, so transducer having, first you have to give input and get output. So maybe input increase means output also increase. The output will decrease means it is not a linearity. So it is a non-linearity. So just you have to reduce the non-linearity effect. Okay, that is the first factor. Second one is, so low hysteresis error. So to reduce the hysteresis effect in the transducer. And the third one is high resolution. So resolution nothing but to get a exact value. Okay, so what is the original value, just you have to get a output. And last one is high degree of high degree of repeatability. Repeatability means okay, this you have to measure the first set of reading. Okay, after some time this you have to the same transducer, this you have to measure the same parameter, it get a same value means before value. Okay, the before value and now current second value also more or less same. Some percentage of errors are allowed, but that is to be limited. Okay, so how many times you have to take a reading should be measured in the same amount of quantity. That means repeatability. So it is a high degree of repeatability. It is a static characteristic under the consideration in static characteristics. So the final classification is final type of selection of transducer is cost and availability. Cost and availability. So just you have to purchase any transducer means it is available in market. Okay, easily available in market. So you have to select that kind of transducer, and cost wise it should be a minimum level, and also some this kind of transducer are having a minimum calibration because it measured in it is a nowadays a current trends. It is to be integrated. Okay, all the it is fabricated in single chip format. Okay, so there is no calibration is needed, and it should not be any component limitation. So there is no limitations, and it should be a preferably small in size. So the space is reduced. Okay, the compactable size. Okay, so the electrical circuitry design is very less. So that the overall is you have to consider this, the overall cost will be decreased. Okay, so students are able to understand the concept of a selection of transducer. If any doubt, please ask me. Okay.